So now we're going to talk about forms or questionnaires. You would go here to evaluations, forms, and it's super easy to create a form. Let's create a new one right here. We'll call it register evaluate. Here on the right side are the tests or information fields that are in this form. Right now it's empty. Down here, you can add tests or information fields or training load. So we want this to register body weight. We add a test. This opens up the test collection, the body weight test here. And I also want to add a question. So I click on add information. This opens up the information collection. I wanted to ask a question I wanted the athlete to write a little bit about how they feel. I don't have that item in my collection, but I can create it on the fly right here. Okay, that's good. Text. All right. And that's it. Now I have a form ready to send it out. Now, there are two ways of sending out forms. You can either here in this window, down here, click on this button, green plus, to assign it to one more athlete, or you can go to the calendar and pick out any form to be connected to a session. I will show that later. So let's start here by assigning it to an athlete. I'm only going to assign it my test athlete here, Bobby Kersey. So I just double clicked here to the right side, press OK. When you assign a form here, you can decide if it's going to be sent out once, and it starts when the athlete gets a notification about it. I'm going to do this in the morning. You can also have it daily, monthly, days of week. And it can be ongoing, or you can put a stop date on it as well. I'm happy with this. I press OK. And then I can see here what athletes are on different forms, or when you select the form, you will see which athletes are on it. And if you double click on this line here, you can change the parameter for the sendouts. You can also exit out here. So if you have many athletes, you can multi-select them and press this X to remove the sendout. So now I'm here on the phone. I can see Bobby already had readiness form assigned to him. We'll take a look at that too, but let's first look at the registered body weight. So he will get this once a week. I click here on register body weight, the phone, and this is how it opens up. So register my body weight right here, and then I can write information about how I feel. Now in this field, you can press return, you can write as much as you want. If you have text fields like these, and a lot of them, where athletes are writing a lot of text, you might want to advise them that they can log in on the web as well, where they will also have these forms, just because it might be easier to write on a keyboard. And to log on to the web browser version, it's app.xpsnetwork.com, or you can simply go to sidelinesports.com and log in. But we go back to here, right? Press submit. So now the information has already been registered here, so I could now go to information here to see the information answers, test results to see the test result answers, or the athlete profile if I've added these into reports. That's how easy it is. Now let's take a look at a few different examples. Readiness, this was simply, I added a combined test, the readiness combined test. And if you remember from the test tutorial, this is a test that combines many different answers. Here's on the phone, now I click readiness. And this was combined of 6 different questions or tests, which we're using labels for values. So I can go in here, mark this in, submit, and then that one is ready. Here's one that's a little bit different. It gets a little bit more advanced. It has 3 sections. If you right click here, the forms area, you can create a new section. And so in a section, you can then add, it's almost like a folder. You can add tests and information and so on. Yeah, let's assign this one to Bobby too. You can see how that looks. I'm just going to drag down with the thumb here to refresh. So there's the 20 report. Now if I click that, you can see that this is how three sections look like. So I have five questions in here, three in here, and three in here. So that's one example. Let's play around a little bit with this one. So let's say maybe I don't want three sections, one section, but I could put this into different steps. So now I right click section here, put in a new step. Yeah, this could call information. This here, then another step. All right, so let's take a look at that. So now you see that I open up right away in the information step. So I would finish this. It's the first of three sections. When I'm finished, I can click next here, and then I'm in keep, stop, start. I can fill this in, I can go back or next. And then when I'm done, I just press up. Okay, so that's how step works. And the last thing to show here is labels. So inside sections or steps, you can, sometimes you have a question that needs a little bit more context or explanation. Let's say for long-term goals here, add a right click here and add a label. And then I write, okay. And I drag that above the term goal here. So here you can see that where the label is now ahead of this field. Let's talk a little bit about training load. These are simply categorizations of your RPE measurements. So this is the standard RPE, but a better way to do this is not to assign training load forms here, delete it from here, but rather go to the calendar and we open up the practice session, go here to attachment and forms link. We can click forms here. Now we press add. We add the training load team training form. And we want to send our notifications 10 minutes after. Now if we had a form that we wanted the players to answer before training, we would have a minus number in here. This is fine and we want to make this default for all future practices that we plan. Now the nice thing about attaching a form this way is that they will only appear when there are sessions, and also the duration of the session will automatically be pre-filled. This is the one now that came with the practice, and when the player athlete goes in here, you see the 70 minutes is already pre-filled here, so they only have to register how hard it was and press submit. And this is also why it's smart to split up, because when you click add training load, you have many categories of training load, and that just has to do with the statistics in the reports when you, how you want to divide it up. But that's why you have one that's game competition, so you can create a specific form for that and just attach that to the game sessions in your calendar. And the same with individual training, because you can go to the calendar, you can go and attach this to workouts, and then you get, when you attach it to workouts, you can also make this setting here so that you add these forms to future workouts created by athletes. So if they create a workout by themselves in their phone, the training load form would be added automatically for them. The last thing to mention here is I'm logged in as a coach now. And sometimes coaches have logged in on an iPad to have in the weight room or somewhere, because then you as a coach, you have access to all of the players and the athletes. With an iPad, for example, you can just have the players select themselves. And if you have a daily form that they need to fill in, they can do that on the iPad. This is also nice that you can go in on your app and see what forms are being assigned and so on. All right. Thank you for listening.